greetings, fellow oldlings. So, if this place looks different to you, it's because I was the victim of one of the most vicious tragedies which a gamer can ever face. I lost my save files and had to start all over again. And, well, here we are. Right now I'm in a different place on High Rock. It's called Reich Corigate. So, it's like a completely different map, completely different places and all. And, yeah. So basically I had to start all over again. But, on the bright side, this time around the loot and whatever I got was amazing. Just like, look at this guy. Just look at him, he looks so badass right now. He's got the silver helm and he's got steel braces, and actually could manage to get a double shield this time around. Yeah, I mean, this actually turned out for the better. And the role, I don't think it's as good as it was the last time around. But yeah, I did some researching. So before that, what I was trying to do was, I was trying to figure out how to proceed with the game, you know, like just explore different stuff and trying to figure out how we actually get on the main quest line. So it turns out that you can't just walk out of the city gates like you could in Skyrim and expect to like just find, you know, the next city to travel to. What you need to do is you need to right click the map like this and it'll tell you where you can and cannot go. So that's I guess that's just a part of the learning curve for this game. So Empire of Tamriel, I don't think it's really an empire. I mean, the Imperial province is pretty much what Tiber Septim had conquered, and well, basically it's been being beaten back into shape by Morrowind right now with Uriel Septim and all, you know, there are civil wars and stuff going on around here. So yeah, I think I'll need to be traveling to, you know, various parts all over Tamriel and actually like fetching the different parts of the stuff and well, basically crafting it all over again, basically making the stuff. And then the plan is to get into Oblivion and basically free Uriel Septim 7, the true Uriel Septim 7, not Yggdrasil, the battle mage who's basically taken his place. And the place definitely has a different taste, it's got a different culture. I mean, the people are not as rude here as they were in the previous cities, they're actually more helpful. So I think, yeah, I like this place. And I did a little bit of research, and apparently, yeah, I mean, you see all these negative numbers, the lower these numbers are, the better it is supposed to be. So yeah, that's something. I also got like a lot of stuff that I could use, and I think I'm gonna go ahead and buy a spear weapon right now, so that which I can use. So let's go. Oh, that is pretty polite of these guys. A cup of warm cider I shall graciously accept. I don't know why I keep turning the other way around. I mean, turning to the left would probably be much closer. Hello, mountain of a man. Let's buy some weapons from you. What should we buy as a secondary weapon? I mean, I don't exactly want to buy a war axe, like a two-handed weapon. So, I mean, this, look at this shop. It's got so much, so many more options here. Like mithril, claymore, ebony mace, 5,000 gold, 1,500 gold. That sounds like super expensive, but then again, I mean, it's actually like pretty good. I'd say I take that. It's got so much more option to it. So I think I'm gonna go for a katana, because I do have a tower shield, which looks badass, by the way. Let's try here. 25 gold. I shall give you 19. How about 19? No, I think I'm gonna stick to 19. Thank you very much. So I basically found this exploit here, wherein I can get stuff for, you know, very cheap as long as I keep spamming the same number which I did. And that's really not how you're supposed to use a katana, but oh well, I mean, for the sake of the game. So we'll just stick to the broadsword for now, and let's see if we can actually get a broadsword repaired, because we did do quite a bit of battle with it. So, repair the broadsword. Nah. Zero. I want to wait 0 days. Yeah, I forgot that you actually have to... So basically read some guides online, basically on the unofficial Elder Scrolls pages, and they were actually pretty helpful. So I forgot the fact that you actually have to wait for some time before you can actually repair some stuff. Well, let me show you something. So apparently in the night there is crime as well, because right here, right as I was turning into this little alleyway, I got attacked by like ambushed by 5 entire goblins, and yeah, they ended up getting more gold, so that's good. I mean, that was fun. So let's see here. So next stop would be Hammerfell, so let's try going to Hammerfell. I don't really know how this stuff's going to work out, so Hammerfell, Thorstad place. I mean, that's... Oh, wait, yeah. Burkard City, Scaven, Heldron Mount, Dragonstar, Dragon Gate, Cliff Keep, Burkard Guard, Stonedale, Wilknev Town. I mean, they did... The guide did tell me that, you know, that I have to go to a certain place, but I don't exactly remember right now. So, yeah, I'm just gonna have to, I guess, go into this random place, and I think it was Stonemoor, as far as I remember. Perhaps Stonedale. I don't remember. Stonedale. That's a pretty English name. Rihad. Really, Rihad. Chosen a destination city, town, or village. That's quite cool. So I guess we will go to Scaven and we shall check more. Based on the current weather, it will take you 40 days to travel here. Oh my. Okay. Let's go, I guess. Traveling. That's a nice little animation. So it took me 40 days of travel and... Ooh, now that's some funky Arabian music. Anyway, you have arrived in the city-state of Scaven in the Hammerfell province. Hammerfell province. Since on, it took 40 days to reach your goal. You know, not indeed, for it is rare indeed to receive travelers brave enough to stand in the shadow of our land. Wow. Let's hope I didn't make a mistake in coming here. It's so rainy. Wow, just look at that, would you? There's so much more diversity in all of the places here. These people actually look like, you know... I mean, it's raining and they're all scantily clad and stuff like that. It's super hot. It might as well be, I don't know. But yeah, there's so much mud here anyway. Let's try asking about Fanglia. Someone at the palace said that they found something in Rihad. You might try there. Thank you very much. I guess I shall just go to Rihad then. And let's see, let's try and roll with it and see what comes up and what doesn't. So... Yeah, so... Hammerfell again. I mean, I don't exactly want to bore you guys, or even myself to be honest, with pointless travel. It'll take 18 days for me to get there. No problem, let's go. So, yeah, I mean, I don't really think there is much here, but let's see. Let's see how it goes. Hammer... Rihad, the southernmost part of Hammerfell, welcomes thee. Lay aside thy vice and avarice and enter these walls as nobles. We wish you only a long life and prosperity. A long life and prosperity without vices, man. That is a tall order. Anyway, I'll just go back here and... Actually, I don't really need to go back there. Yeah, I'll just mark the city gates here for a moment. And... we should be good. And what is this? Ah, yes, this is a stone golem, I think. I wonder what this place is. So you can actually right-click on places to identify them. And this guy here is a priest. Sinful nod, really? Really? okay, so where would be the nearest inn? Because... Yeah, wait. No. Yeah, where is the nearest inn? Well, thank you very much, I suppose. Okay, so it is either this or this, so let's check it out. Because I need to wait until the morning before I can actually do anything, because otherwise, well... I wonder if the inns here are different, but yeah, I mean, during the night all the places are closed and I can't really do much about it, but in the mornings it's, I mean, everything is open, like churches and stuff, churches and shops and stuff, they're all open, so... This place really seems to be decorated with, are you like a god? Oh my god, really? Why are you attacking? Mate. Stop. I'm leaving, alright? I am leaving. Oh my god, let him leave, come on! Dude. I mean, it was funny, the guy was attacking, but I didn't take, like, any damage, so... That was cool. Well, do I really need to kill you, mate? Yeah, I think I do. Let's see who can swing the sword faster. That was a hit. So this is basically... their earliest take on... Well... Cool. I killed it this dude. So I'm now officially a murderer, I guess. I don't know. 50 gold pieces. Oh my god, so much stuff. Like, really. Yeah, I'm gonna take as much of this as I can. That was a thief! Well, that's something. So I go back and I turn left. I guess that was the place. I totally missed it. And the priest was just standing there chilling while this dude is trying to kill me right in broad daylight. But oh well. I guess that's just how stuff rolls in this game. Okay, so this is not the place. The other side it is then. So that's what I was talking about back then. I mean, this game actually has crime. Goblins and people will actually try to attack you in the middle of the night. So it's best to stay in. I mean, I sort of understood that the guy was not a... like, not a part of the guard. Wait, this isn't it either? Huh, that is quite strange. Oh, it's that one over here. So see, that's the thing about these places. I mean, all the places have got like a different atmosphere. So, I mean, back then, back there in High Rock, all the inns had like crescent moons on them. Over here, they don't. They just, you know, they're just well decorated. Oh yeah, that's the whipping lady over there. Too bad she didn't. Before we reach the bar, an aggressive person called Babank of the House of Truth signals you and speaks in a conspirational whisper. You see, I loaned a scrap of Balrog hide of sentimental value to someone in the Mage's Guild, and now I find I must have it back. Would you get it for me? Scrap metal, but worth a first seed. Do we have a deal? Sure. So hello, there are all these people. Could you like, yeah, thank you. Wow, you're not really friendly, are you? Wait, where was I supposed to go again? Whew. Hold up, let me just check my logbook. Oh yeah, the Mage's Guild. I thought it was a temple. So west it is. I mean, I guess with the walking pace in this game, you could call this a walking simulator. I mean, is this really a walking simulator? Is it? What do you guys think? I mean, they sure walk really slow. All these people are so tall, man. I mean, seems a little, you know. Anyway. So, as far as the Mage's Guild is concerned, but look at this, I mean, the draw distance is so clear here. There's like literally zero fog covering up this entire place, so that's something. I guess I'll ask the suit as soon as it stops. Oh yeah, thank you. I actually overshot. Well, that's something. Is this a place? I don't know, I mean, the Mage's Guild was supposed to be like a huge place. This is a huge place, but I don't really know if this is the Mage's Guild. Yeah, no, it isn't. So this is just one of the things about the game you really need to explore and see how things are. What is this? A wyvern? A worm? This definitely looks like the Mage's Guild. It could be. It should be. I mean, this isn't identifying as anything, so I guess it's not the door? This might just be a dungeon, like a minor dungeon. All cities have them, so I mean, you can raid them if you want to just pass some time in a game with graphics as shitty as this, but yeah. Is this the Mage's Guild? You know, I feel like that meme guy, you know? The one who looks at the butterfly and goes, is this the butterfly? And this probably is the Mage's Guild. Oh, don't play yourself like that. You can tell me where the Mage's Guild is. Yeah, it's probably right behind this guy or girl, whatever. Girl, yeah. Ah, it's behind me, actually, almost. Turn left, turn left. Okay. This was the Mage's Guild. I just couldn't find the door. Fifty-eight days of traveling. Yep. I like how they put the Eye of Ra on the door. Well, at least the wizard doesn't look any different here. So, yeah. Here. Tell Blubamka I said thank you. Well, okay, let's see if we can purchase some. This is too expensive, so I guess I'll just purchase a potion of healing. Just one, thank you. Yeah, no, I'll offer you 37 for that. I'll go with it. 38. How about still 38? Good, thank you very much. I sort of feel like a monster for exploiting these guys, the mechanics of this game, but it is what it is, you know. Okay, so let me ask you guys, one of you guys. Hey, stop. Yeah. Where is the nearest door? West of here. I only want to ask you the easy questions, man. I don't exactly want to, you know, ask you the meaning of life and stuff like that. Why do you all get so nervous? Excuse me. I mean, it's raining here, so I'm a bit under the weather. My voice is a little hoarse. Yeah, but apart from that, it's all cool. The beautiful graphics. I mean, the background is pretty detailed, so that's one thing. I actually like that about Hammerfell. I mean, you can actually see the background. Unlike in in High Rock. It was all foggy all the time. Is there any person I can talk to? Oh yeah, thank you very much, young lady. So where is nearest door? Well, thank you very much. You've been utmost helpful. Okay. Go straight, take a left, and you have it. Through the narrow alleyways. Is this it? Oh no, not really. I actually passed it. Okay. Don't tell me I have to go in here. Oh yes, I do. The door isn't this way, the door is on the other side. Man, this game makes you... Well, at least you get to... You know, I was about to say this game makes you walk a lot, but then again, you get to appreciate the pixel art quite well. And the stunning frame rates. So I'm guessing the door is supposed to be in here? Somewhere? Yes? No? Where is the store? I missed the entrance again. Wow. Yeah, you know, I think I'm gonna circle back around from this side. Ooh. Female armor in games. Yeah, no, I don't want to talk to you. Don't worry. So, get out of the way, Paul, come on. So this is basically where we had to go. I mean, if they had a V-Sync option for this game, I would take it. Definitely. Thank you. at least some blacksmiths at the same here. So yeah, leather greaves. Yeah, I'm sure we can do better than the Harbour 17. Time to enter the huge castle of Rihad. Rihad, not Rihad. Think of politics as such a day. People are lining up to be heard by Queen. Yeah, Blubamka. Blubamka. I don't know how to say that. While outside, newly bloomed flowers perfume the air. Well, that I suppose that makes the appropriate atmosphere for politics. Look at all these guards. Main hall. Yeah, that's pretty much as far as you go, because on my last save I actually tried exploring the castles a little bit. You can go to the left, you can go to the right, but sometimes behind a few doors you'll find some, like, well-armored guards that'll, you know, come out and try to kill you if you access those areas. I mean, as soon as you exit the castle, it's all fine, they won't be chasing anymore, you can enter back in and they won't really do much to you. But during the time that you actually, like, enter the castle, try and enter those areas, these guards with, you know, all, I think, silver armor, because these guys look like they were wearing, like, plate armor and stuff, or cloth on them. Those guys had, like, really shiny silver armor, and when I say shiny, I mean shiny, just a moment. So excuse me. So, sorry about that. I'm actually surrounded by a lot of disturbing people disturbing me, so yeah. Anyway, so as I was saying, those guards, they're like really well armored from head to toe, complete with, you know, broadswords and plate armor and stuff, so they can fuck you pretty bad, is what I'm trying to say. So yeah, it's better if you avoid them and don't roam too much about in the castle. Welcome to Rihad, Grimfangs. I'm Queen Blubamka, and I agreed to tell you about Fangler for a favor. You see, not too long ago, a band of goblins led by Galtok the Dark attacked the stronghold. They carried away with them much treasure, including a parchment which held within its writings clues to decipher the part of the Elder Scrolls which spoke of the location of the legendary Fangler. Ah, okay, I see. Galtok and his goblins fled to an ancient and ruined fortress called Stone Keep outside the city. I fear that a large band of mercenaries or soldiers will be unable to find them. A single person, however, would be much more successful. Perhaps your arrival is fortuitous. If you would agree to try and recover this parchment, I will inscribe the location of this Stone Keep onto your map. If you are successful in returning the parchment, I will be able to decipher the location of Fanglair. I promise to give you that location as reward for your help. Do you agree? Of course I do. Excellent. Stone Keep lies near Rihad. Be careful. Galtok is crafty and evil. It is even rumored that he is a necromancer serving the Underking. When you have the parchment, return with it here and I will find out the location of Fanglair for you. She smiles broadly, motions for me to take my leave, which I will do. I don't want to get impaled by guards at this point. Bye-bye.